Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info.
On August 17, 2017, the Thunderbolts Project will begin its international conference, Future Science, in Phoenix, Arizona. At the conference, speakers from a variety of disciplines, including engineering, physics, mathematics, and the life sciences will present new, groundbreaking research on the role of electricity in nature. A keynote speaker will be Professor Donald Scott, who has spent recent years developing his own model of the structure of a Birkeland current. As noted in several Space News episodes, in recent years, the term Birkeland current has increasingly appeared in scientific literature, with scientists recognizing the role the currents play in earthly auroras and other atmospheric phenomena. Recently, Dr. Scott's prediction that the unique signature of Birkeland currents is their counter-rotation has been visually verified. At the Thunderbolts conference, Dr. Scott will discuss his investigation into the role of cosmic Birkeland currents and the evidence that these currents power many galaxies in deep space.
We in the Electric Universe are involved in the investigation of things that happened very long ago or far, far away. And one of the challenging things about that is trying to get any kind of hard, substantive evidence to support your ideas. And hopefully we can come up with, at least we always look for, evidence that interlocks with other evidence. Anyway, we've long suspected that electrical currents flow through cosmic space and they have real effects on things that we can observe. For example, Christian Birkeland predicted that the cause of the Earth's auroras were electric currents, and he was right. And now we can call them Birkeland currents in his honor. They are there. They flow down into the north and south poles of Earth, and they've been measured, and they're now known to exist. Nobody really argues about that anymore. We've suspected that if it was true about the Earth, though, it might be true about other planets as well. So how can we obtain supporting evidence for that, other than maybe going there and measuring them with a space probe? Well, a couple of years ago, I was able to develop a mathematical model for what the structure of a Birkeland current would probably look like if we could actually see one and take it apart and dissect it. Actually, Birkeland currents have a unique structure, totally unique. They consist of a collection of concentric cylinders that counter-rotate, like a bunch of pipes inside one another, each one going in the opposite direction from the ones on either side of it. Or I shouldn't say either side of it, but inside it or outside of it. Anyway, each cylinder, one inside the other, rotates in the opposite direction from its neighbor. So when I saw that the north poles of both Saturn and Jupiter are covered with counter-rotating cloud belts, now that was the kind of corroboration that's hard to ignore. Counter-rotation is almost uniquely a property of Birkeland currents. Doesn't mean it can't happen from other means, but it's very, very difficult. Try to think of it yourself. How do you make these cylinders go in the opposite directions? That's very tough. That's a tough problem. So when we see it, we're encouraged to think that we may be seeing a situation in which Birkeland currents are present, or at least we should allow for the possibility that that's what's going on. The Earth's auroras exhibit counter-rotation, and so that's additional supporting evidence that indeed, yes, Birkeland currents are impinging on the North Pole and South Pole of the Earth. So why not on Saturn, Jupiter, and the other planets? We see these counter-rotating cloud belts, and that supports our ideas. So we also think, however, that strings of Birkeland currents connect galaxies in our universe. If we can show that lots of these galaxies contain counter-rotating belts of stars, that would be strong evidence for the presence of Birkeland currents. Otherwise, how do you get those belts of stars to go in opposite directions? In this summer's EU conference, I'm going to present evidence of a lot of galactic counter-rotation. That astronomers claim that this is very rare, that very few galaxies exhibit this. Well, maybe. But it's quite difficult to observe and measure, and I will try to show the folks at the conference how that's done. Does that prove that Birkeland currents are responsible for galactic rotation? No, of course not. But it's very difficult to come up with another mechanism that can produce galaxy counter-rotation that isn't electrical, that isn't a Birkeland current. Anyway, lastly, at the conference, sort of talking about the other end of the spectrum of dimension, from the huge galaxies to something very small on the other end, relatively small at least, We suspect that storms here on Earth may involve Birkeland currents, and I'm going to be presenting new evidence that they indeed are. They're intimately involved with both hurricanes and tornadoes. Also, this last week, I discovered, thanks to my my informants who say, hey, Don, you should see this. And so a fellow sent me a website showing that Birkeland currents are a possible explanation of the mysterious circulating ocean currents, like, for instance, the Gulf Stream. People have been asking for decades, centuries, actually millennia, as to why do these big streams, these oceanic rivers of water flow around and around and around. What drives them? You can hear people talk about dynamos inside the earth or something, but that's like the dog ate my homework kind of explanation. They are, we think, now quite obviously the result of those Birkeland currents that come into the poles of the earth. And I will be talking about that and presenting evidence to that effect in August, and I look forward to it.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.